Now the next topic, accuracy. The accuracy of a measurement is the measure of how close the measured value is to the true value of the quantity. That means it represents the closeness of the measured value to the true value. Accuracy depends on what factors? The accuracy in measurement may depend upon the several factors like the personal errors. But the reason of the personal error is imperfection in the technique or the procedure used by the observer, instrumental errors, that is defect in the instrument, errors due to the external causes like the effect of the supply voltage, temperature, pressure, mechanical strain, etc. And the fourth one is the random errors. We have already discussed what are the random errors. It is due to the irregular way. It is only due to the carelessness of the observer. Poor accuracy involves the errors that can often be corrected. By using or eliminating the above mentioned factors, we can improve the accuracy. As the errors are reduced, accuracy in the measurement increases. Then the term is precision. What is precision? Precision tells us to what resolution or limit the quantity is measured by a measuring instrument. That it represents the limit of the resolution of a instrument. Precision is determined by the least count of the measuring instrument. Lesser the least count, greater is the precision. What is least count? Least count is the minimum value that can be measured by a given instrument. For example, least count of a vernier caliper is often 0.01 cm and the least count of the screw gauge is 0.001 cm. Therefore, the measurement of the small length using a screw gauge or the spirometer will be more precise than the same measurement using a vernier caliper, as the least count of vernier calipers is 0.01 cm and the least count of the screw gauge or the spirometer is 0.001 cm, that the screw gauge and the spirometer can be resolved more as compared to the vernier caliper. Similarly, a vernier screw gauge or the spirometer with the least count 0.0005 cm will be more precise than the one with the least count 0.001 cm. That is, greater the resolution of the instrument, the greater will be the precision. Now the significant figures. The digit data known reliably plus the first uncertain digits are known as the significant figures. For example, suppose the distance is 458.3 meter. It has four significant figures 4, 5, 8 and 3. The digits 4, 5, 8 and 3 are reliable while the digit 3 is uncertain. Larger the number of significant figures in a measurement, greater is the precision of the measurement and the vice versa. Now, next, the rules for the counting of the significant figures. Rule 1. All non-zero digits are significant. All non-zero digits means other than zero. For example, y is a physical quantity. It is represented as y equal to 3216. It has four significant figures. Rule 2. All zeros occurring between the two non-zero digits are significant, no matter where the decimal point is. For example, x is a physical quantity which is equal to 2005, has four significant figures, because in between the two non-zero figures 2 and 5 there are two zeros. According to the rule, this also be included in the significant digits. Therefore, it has four significant digits. Similarly, another quantity x is equal to 1.0503 has the five significant figures. Next rule, third rule, if the number is less than 1, the zero on the right of the decimal point and to the left of the first non-zero digits are not significant. For example, in 0.002305, the first three zeros, one at the left hand side of the decimal point and two at the right side of the decimal point, are not significant. According to the rule, the zeros between 3 and 5 is significant, which is according to the rule 2. Hence, the number of the significant figures is 4. Next rule, rule 4. In a number with a decimal point, the terminal or the training zeros are not significant. For example, x is equal to 9870 has three significant figures 9, 8 and 7. The terminal or the ending 0 is not taken as significant. Rule 5. However, in a number with decimal point, the trailing zeros are significant. For example, x is equal to 5.6000 has five significant figures. As according to the rule, on the right side of the decimal point, number of the zeros with the non-zero will be taken as the significant figures. Similarly, y is equal to 0.00456000 has six significant figures. The first three zeros will not be significant according to the rule 3. And next, the zeros after the three non-zero numbers 4, 5, 6 will be included as the significant figures. Therefore, the total 4, 5, 6 and three zeros, total six significant figures are present in this number. Rule 6. The digit 0 conventionally put on the left of a decimal for a number less than 1 is never significant. For example, 0.8270 has four significant figures. The underlined 0 is not significant, which has been taken in the rule number 2. Now, rule number 7. Change of unit does not change the number of significant figures in a measurement. That is, it does not depend upon the system of unit. For example, the length 2.340 cm has four significant figures 2, 3, 4 and 0. In different system of unit, the same length can be written as 0.02340 m. and 23.40 mm. The lengths are expressed in the three different system of units, centimeter, meter and millimeter. But in the three cases, the number of the significant figures is same, that is 4. Rule number 8. The multiplying or dividing factors which are neither rounded numbers nor numbers representing measured values are exact. They have infinite number of significant digits as per the situation. For example, in radius, diameter which is equal to the diameter upon 2 and circumference is equal to 2 pi r. The factor 2 is an exact number. Diameter upon 2 and the circumference formula 2 pi r. 2 is an exact number. It can be written as 2.0, 2.00, 2.000, 2.4 times 0, 2. Anything.